Hi, today we're going to be taking an unboxing review look at Battlefield 1 for PS4. So, Battlefield 1 for PS4, made by DICE and EA, with M for Mature, 17 plus. So you can have an epic 64 player multi battle. So, one player for single campaign, 40 gigabytes minimum memory on the hard drive. So you can have between 2 and 64 players. So, way more players online multiplayer in one match than, in Call of Duty, that you have like maybe 6v6 or 12v12 or something like that. So, a lot more players. You can use remote play. PS Vita and all that stuff. So yeah, this was a so-called pre-owned one. So I got it for a cheaper price and stuff. So let's open it up. So, telling you, don't forget to buy the season pass. That's all that one. And this one, unfortunately, already ended. But it was that if you bought Battlefield 1, you got special skins for Titanfall 2, the Red Baron war paint. And here's all the stuff you had to do. Sign into the Battlefield 1 and Titanfall 2, same AE account. And then, oh, before December. Okay, so that's weird. It's saying available 10/28/16, but here it's saying to unlock your reward December 1st, 2017. That's kind of weird. Available. Okay, anyway. So yeah, that's how you get that for Titanfall 2. So, as you know, usually I'm a big Call of Duty fan. I love everything Call of Duty. And for a lot of years, I was always starting to lose my voice and getting sick here. Excuse me. I fear I might be coming down with a cold or something. I got a stuffy nose. So, if my voice sounds a little wet on this video, that's why. Anyway, like I was saying, for years I've been a Call of Duty fan, just love Call of Duty. I was always against Battlefield, but this year I am the complete opposite. When Call of Duty messed up twice in both games, which I guess you could kind of say three or five, however you want to do it, but let's just say two games for short, Call of Duty Infinity Warfare across the board, the campaign, not that great. The multiplayer, no fun at all. A lot of weapon balance issues, wasn't balanced at all. The tacticals, the lethal grenades, the guns, the movement systems, the specialists, or whatever the heck they're calling them in Infinity Warfare. I don't even remember anymore. I just put my stop playing Call of Duty altogether this year. Their so-called abilities and weapons, which were just cheap, watered-down rip-offs of Call of Duty Blast 3, which had great specialists, great, abilities and weapons that, you have either kill people or wait over time for them to charge up so you can use the abilities and specialized weapons and stuff. Great camos, great stuff. Call of Duty Blast 3, they knew how to at least put together a Call of Duty game. Infinity Warfare, they ripped off Advanced Warfare. They ripped off Ghost, but without the, Ghost leaning system to peek and shoot around the corners, so we don't have that. They ripped off Blast Freeze. So much of Blast Freeze has been ripped off. The wall running. It's bad. Black Ops 3 had better wall running. You can't even go scuba diving and swim. Black Ops 3, at least you could get in the water. You could swim on the water. The characters, your little specialist characters, Black Ops 3, you could turn around, see what the heads and the bodies look like when you equip new heads and bodies on some person. This one, no. All the cameras look horrible. For the specialists, for the weapons, it was just horrible. Not even multiplayer, but zombies are too OP. Round one, round two, one zombie goes up through the window and just, smash you. And I need someone to revive me, I'm down. Too OP in the zombies, the masks were hard, turn all the power and stuff, and buying all the doors to get to power. Infinity Warfare is garbage across the board on Call of Duty. And then you have, what a lot of people call, say, Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare Remastered is garbage, I have to say. Now, I know a lot of people out there watching Call of Duty and they love Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare be like, "Whoa, man, why are you saying it's garbage?" But it is. Not to get me wrong, Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare for the respective, back in the day, PS3 and Xbox 360, in its respective consoles, back in the day, it was awesome. It was fantastic. I loved it. I'm saying, the original, back in the day, was the best. The remastered, horrible. Now, I do like kind of like how they have some new melee weapons, like, the Bolt and Beer Bottle. That doesn't change the game. That's, just a reskin of the knife. We've seen that in Black Ops 3. Obviously, with baseball bats and crowbars and, all that stuff. Weapon camos, they're nice. You get to have new characters instead of playing as one soldier. You could be a guy, you could be a girl, you could put, brown pants suit on them and, go all out drab or OD, so they could wear different camos and stuff. The camos for the weapons, I like how instead of just having that reflex red dot sight, you could have, a tombstone, little daggers, stars. Fill the horns, let's watch tonight! This game, watch, that I appreciate it. But when they start dropping, like, a new shotgun, a new assault rifle, a 44 Magnum revolver, that's starting to change the game and make it bad. So that's kind of what. Oh, and Infinity Warfare, when you get in a lobby, you're waiting like maybe 2, 3 hours just like the beta to get into a game, and then people are like, Tessa's in the game. They all back out. It's like, why? Why even do it? And then if you go to trade it in at GameStop, it's $5 cash or $7 store credit. And you're like, I spent like $100 on the Pro Legacy Edition, so not only am I getting Call of Duty, Infinity Warfare, but you had to buy like at least $100 one, I believe, the Pro Legacy, to get Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare Remastered, and both games are not great, and they only get you between $5 and $7 on a $100 game. That's BS. BS. Completely on Call of Duty's fault. And what happened? It was like 2.5, maybe 3 months for leaderboards to finally appear in the game? They should have been in there on day one! Oh my god, Call of Duty. They messed up big time! They should get down their knees and beg for David Reinhardt to get back. I know a lot of people, Blast 2, didn't like David Reinhardt. Blast 3, he didn't get as much criticism in Black Ops 3 as he did in Black Ops 2, but at least Black Ops 3, you're still able to get on and play the game. They should really get back to David Reinhardt, get down on knees, beg him, please, please, David Reinhardt, we need you to fix Call of Duty. They should do that. But no. What do? They lay off 20 employees for messing up Call of Duty Infinity Warfare. With some people like, yay, they got fired and laid off. Other people like, no, they shouldn't. How do I feel about it? I mean, they shouldn't get fired for messing up on a game. They should go back and actually fix the game. I don't believe that they should have got fired for it. Because, today's economy, they shouldn't. But they should at least fix the game, or at least make the game where it wasn't able that it needed to be fixed. So I know this video is kind of about Battlefield, but I'm telling the difference between Battlefield and Call of Duty. Why I switch over to Battlefield instead of playing Call of Duty. A lot of YouTubers like Drifter, T-Mod, and they don't even play like Call of Duty that much. They don't advertise it, they don't go to like the conventions and bail for like 5,000 hours and stuff. They don't do that. T-Mod said he doesn't even buy Call of Duty DLC 1. He was like, I hadn't bought DLC 1 for Call of Duty and I'm not planning on buying it or the next one. Call of Duty is bad. Now I appreciate people like that. That's not for it to tell you that a game is bad. And yes, they are getting paid for these reviews. I'm not, but they are, as you know. Like Charlie, Chaos Silencer, T-Mod, and Drifter. So when they're not posting videos like Call of Duty, they're not making money. But it's good on them that they're not like, this game's awesome, even though in reality it's like, this game is a piece of garbage. But Battlefield 1 is pretty awesome. Here from like GameStop, they had it on sale, so I kind of got a little bit of a deal on it. Now, some tips and tricks for Battlefield that you should always do: spotting people. On a PS4, hit the R1, aim down sights and then hit the R1 button. Spot people, it lights them up. It's almost like a U. It'll be either to kind of a UAV or a SATCOM from Call of Duty Ghosts or any other Call of Duties. That's the only way that you could see people. So, I mean, people could fire their gun and all day long in Battlefield, and the only way to see them is if you actually spot them and light them up for your team. You don't show up on no radar map, it's not like, oh, I gotta put some plus signs on my gun so I don't show up so no one will know where I'm at. Nope, the only way that people's gonna know where you're at is either if they shoot you dead or they spot you and light you up. On Xbox One, I finished the white bumper, and on PC, don't quote me on PC because I don't have a PC or, I don't have it for the PC, and I don't have it for Xbox One, as you can see, I only have it for PS4. But on PC, I believe it's Q that spots people, and classes. If you want to support class, and people saying, give me ammo, you throw down ammo, because that's what's special to a support class. The ones that resupply ammo. If you are a medic, medics, big thing for medics. If you are a medic, throw down some bandages for your teammates. If they're dead, pull out that needle and syringe and revive them. Just stick it in them, and they'll be like, oh, thank you, I'm back in the battle again. Because medics, you're the only class that can throw down bandages and revive your teammates. So when you got someone saying, medic, medic, don't go up to them and be like, ooh, ooh, I'm gonna let you, I'm gonna let you, I'm gonna let you. And they're like, man, I'm down to 3 health from 100 health. You're a medic. Stop doing this, looking at me, trying to teabag me. Fall down some freaking, bayonets. Fold down a whole crate of gauze pads and bandages. Heal me. Do your job. Don't be like, oh, I'm gonna do the teabag. I'm gonna do the warm. And then get both of us killed. When someone's saying they need bandages, they need a medic, and you're a medic, and you're right there. Do your job. That's what you do. Rely on your hippocratic oath, Heal them. Because a SOC can't heal themselves. A SOC can't say, I need a bandage, I'm gonna take a bandage and bandage me. No, they can't do that. Support can't do that. A scout can't do that. Medics, your job is to heal because that's special to your class that you have the stuff to heal. Support, your class is special where it can supply the whole team with ammo. Do that job. Do your job. Well, let's see. So if you may have seen in my other videos earlier, then I was like, oh, I don't really know what these things are. Yeah, that's because I didn't have Battlefield before, so. But here are things. I believe this is called the Landship. Anti-tank grenade, the Luger, Spike Mace. I can't remember what this gun was called, but I believe it's in the support class. I want to say it's in the support class. So yeah, if you watch that video, you're like, oh man, that guy's an idiot. He doesn't know like what that tank is called. Is it a light tank? Is it, called a land ship and stuff? Well, newsflash, didn't have the game, so I couldn't actually tell you exactly, is that a tank? Is that a heavy tank? Is that a light tank? Is that a land ship tank? I couldn't actually tell you because didn't have the game to play to actually say, oh, that's a tank! Fall back! Fall back! So, yeah. Let's see what else. Okay. Yeah, I know in Battlefield you got this medal. I don't remember how you get this medal, but it's a great little dog tag. Kind of funny. And stuff. But yeah. Definitely, if you're on the Battlefield, medics, support quests, do your job, float on medkits, revive, float on ammo. Everyone could spot enemies. Just, aim and tap, 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 tap that button. Let the guy tap it, and when I say spot, you could spot anything to light it up for your team. People, the cavalry, airplanes, like submarine type of ships almost. Tanks. Led Zeppelin like blimps. Yeah. Like those and stuff. Light them up. It's gonna save your teammates when your team is like, oh, I'm gonna go with a one-on-one gunfight. You light them up and like, whoa, I thought there was one guy there. There's four more guys. That's a 5-on-1. I'm not stupid. I'm gonna fall back. Or it's like, oh, I'm gonna fight this one guy, and then they're like, you light up, and they're like, oh, there's a tank there. Yeah, I'm gonna drop down to the ground and crawl my way back to safety. And so, do your job. If you got a guy that's got an AT rocket and they lay on their belly, and they line up right at a tank or the train to take it out, don't be that guy that's like, I got a little handgun. I'm gonna do a belly crawl right on top of you, get in your face. Because that's what happened to me. I could pull a trigger with both of us up with the AT rocket. But I was like, no, I was like, man, do you know that your little pistol, your little Luger pistol is not gonna do any damage to the train? Move to the side. And let me throw my, anti-tank grenades at it. Let me shoot, my, anti-tank rockets, or the AT rockets for short. Those things do damage. Get out of my face and let me take the train out. Because, your little pistol ain't gonna do damage to trains and tanks and stuff. Hey. Support quest. Drop me some ammo so I can resupply my grenades and my rockets so I can focus on that train, take it out, so we have nothing to worry about. But I hate people that's like, they're not spotted. Or when people are in charge and they're like the commander, officer, and you're like, orders. And they're like, I don't know where to go. You're like, there's A, B, C, D, Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Apples, all different ones. You get on there, you point, you say, we're going to Butters, and we go Butters. And everyone's like, oh, let's take Butters. We're going to Butters, which is like B-Dom kind of situation for like domination. So it's like, oh, we're going to Butters. Okay, let's go to Apples, which is like Alpha. Charlie, I think it's always Charlie. But yeah. Tell your team where we're going. What's the objective? Highlight the objective. So everyone on your team's like, oh, Butters is sprinting. That means, we're going to Butters. Tell people, go, 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 go to Butters. Take that so the enemy don't get it. Do your job. If you're a commander, tell people where to go. If you're a medic, heal your people. Revive them. If you're a support quest, fall down ammo so your team can keep on being that fight, throwing grenades, shooting their bullets and stuff. Everyone, light people up, just spot, 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 spot the people and the tanks and everything. Because when you spot, you get a bonus, a score bonus. And even if you don't get that kill from spotting and someone else kills that player, you still get a double score. So you spot someone, you get 50 points. You kill someone, or if someone else kills someone because you spot them, you get another 50 points. Right there, that's 100 points. If you spot and kill, that's like 150 points. So, I mean, spotting is just free points for you. If you're the only guy that's spotting, you're gonna get mad major points to rank up your class, to rank up your level. You're gonna be getting battle pass, you're gonna be getting war bonds so you can buy more stuff. Tips and tricks. Spot. Throw down med kits. Revive with the syringe. Throw down ammo crates. Squad leader, tell your team what we're going for. We're going for apples. We're going for butters. We're going grocery shopping. Soldiers, let's load up on apples and butter. Come on. Tell your team, let's go grocery shopping. Let's mark these things off our shopping list, Tell your team what they should be going for, what they should be focused on. Because I've been getting into a lot of teams that people, they don't know what to do. They don't know how to spot. They don't know how to throw down med kits. I'm like, you're a medic. Do your job. You're a support quest. I need ammo. Throw down ammo. It's like, you're a squad leader. Tell us where to go. Lead us into battle of where we're taking. Are we taking apples? Are we taking butter? Are we taking Edward? Are we taking Freddy? What are we doing? So, depending on what your job is, do your job, and everyone, tip for everyone, spot everything. Major bonus, help your team out, helps you out a lot with points stuff. So yeah, that is the Battlefield 1 unboxing and tips and tricks video. Remember to rate, subscribe, and leave a comment. I know this video was really long, but just had to tell you, some tips and tricks, what to do, what not to do, which is not to do is nothing, what to do everything. So yeah, hope you enjoy. Hope you learn some stuff about spotting. If you're a class and stuff, what class like meta and support, what to do and what not to do and stuff. So yeah, remember to rate, subscribe, and leave a comment. All right, friends, bye.